Hello and welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. My name is Shivam Vijay. Today in this video, I am going to giving a demo on temperature controller trainer using PID and water as a medium. So in this trainer, we are going to control the temperature inside a geyser, which is our temperature medium, using a heater control card, which is a thyristorized based heater control card, which can be convert the power of heater coil and provide voltages accordingly to generate the current inside the heater coil and to set the temperature as per the desired set point. So now we are going to see the experiment on this way, and then we also describe all parts of the complete mimic diagram and the mimic plant mimic of this system. Now I am going to describe about the basic working or functioning of this function or this complete system for controlling the water temperature. This is the sump tank over here. The sump tank has a capacity of 50 to 60 liters of water. The water is already filled inside, and then there is a drain wall about on this side to drain out the water for the system as well. Then this is connected to a centrifugal pump. In this is a auto mode priming centrifugal pump of about half HP of this motor, and this pump throw the water through the rotameter over here. The rotameter is of measuring the water flow from 0 to 1000 liters per hour, and the water flow from the rotameter is going to the inside of inlet to the geyser. The geyser is a heater element in which we will heat the water from inside, and outlet from the geyser is directly connected to the sump tank. So this is our complete flow process of water. The electrical diagram or electrical controlling of all the parts is described in this panel. So now we are going to see what is inside the panel and then explain all the parts one by one. We start describing with this panel. This has a PID controller. This is an advanced PID controller with LCD display in which two of the modes are given. The first line will be give the process value, and the second line will give the set point or set value which we are going to set for this. And the complete setup is easily can be communicated with the SCADA system using serial PC interface, SKI protocol or RS-232. Then there are 5 keys to change and set up the different values inside it. We will see it later also. Then this can be take input of 4 to 20 milliampere. The 4 to 20 milliampere input or the RTD input is connected. The RTD is connected behind the outlet terminal of the geyser. The outlet is directly connected to the T1 and T2. This is the transmitter output. The output is fed to the PID controller as an input, and it will sense the actual value of the temperature. The output from the PID controller is generated in the form of 4 to 20 milliampere as well, and this will given directly to the heater control card which is fitted inside this panel. The heater control card works as per the output given from the PID controller and changes the temperature inside the heater. So this was the basic functioning of this complete setup. Now we will see what inside the panel. These are the mains PID on switch. This is the mains on switch, PID on switch. Then this is the pump on switch to turn on the pump and off. This is the spare switch to check any of the spare values. Now we are going to see what inside the panel. You can unscrew both these bolts to open the panel inside, and then use this handle to open the front opening or front gate of the panel. Inside the panel you will find some elements which are the important one for this. This is the heater control card, which is the most important element for this system. The heater control card takes input in the analog form, which is 4 to 20 milliampere, which is the current input for the DC current, and gives output in 0 to 230 volt AC. This voltage is directly connected to the heater coil, and heater coil, as the voltage changes, the current inside the heater coil flowing will be changes, and the temperature heating of the coil heater will also changes. So that's how we control the heater control card. The heater control card is a thyristorized based control card. This can be easily convert the current or voltage according to the PID input. Then this is the MCB to turn on and off the system. Then these are the terminal blocks which will be connected all the wirings through other components and different devices. Also we have USB to serial converter. In this, the output from the PID controller is connected or converted through this USB to UART bridge, and there is a USB cable here. This will be connected with the PC to controlling some patch codes to connect the input and output, or the pressure transmitter output and PID controller input output. This is the backside from the panel or the PID controller. You can easily understand and check all the values for this. Then we have the process tank, or we can say geyser, in which will all the process for heating up the water will be happen. The capacity of this geyser is 1 liter, and the power consumption is about 3 kilowatt, and this the coil material of the heater is high grade copper for better conductivity with the heater is provided. Then we have connected RTD here. This is a temperature transmitter which is connected in the outlet line of the geyser. So warm water will be flow from this, and the temperature of the warm water will be sensed by this RTD and fed to the PID controller. Then we have the MCB of 16 ampere here to provide the safety purpose of the heater coil, and high power ratings can be used by turning on this MCB so that geyser can be easily controlled outside from the panel. Then this is a rotameter. The rotameter is connected to see the flow of the complete process. So flow is the most important also part. So when we maintain the flow, the temperature or the water inside the heater will be have low flow, so temperature will be quickly get, and if the flow is higher, the temperature cannot be provided because the water flowing from the geyser will be at the higher flow, so it will not heat up properly. So we need to maintain the flow as well. For this we have connected the rotameter here. The rotameter is connected with the half inch BSP thread with the ball valves, and this has the glass tube here. This is a glass tube type of rotameter and can be measured from 100 liters per hour to 1000 liters per hour for accuracy, and the poppet will be going up and down when the flow is going through the rotameter, and we can measure the flow according to the poppet value. And this is the motor here, the centrifugal pump which have a half HP rating motor, and this is a single phase motor here, and motor can be throw water inside the complete process system through the rotameter through to geyser, and after output of the geyser it directly sum to the sump tank, and sump tank is of capacity of about 50 to 60 liters. You have to fill up the sump tanks about 80% so that you have to perform practical very cleanly, and there will no any of the air bubbles present. And the motor is the self prime mode, auto prime mode motor, so you don't need to worry about the priming section. This is the inlet line which is going from the sump tank to directly connected with the motor pump. So pump will flow the water, and then we see and do the practical accordingly. So till now I have given the basic overview and a close look of all the items connected and installed in this complete system for water temperature controlling. In this, the complete setups and complete all the components are fitted in a complete MS coated power frame. The frame has a good capacity of arrangement and can be easily movable by the wheels connected beneath the complete frame. The frame can be easily movable, and you can easily move the frame in the corridors and another room to room at where your institution and other learning process and learning buildings. And with the lock mechanism, you can lock the wheel up and while performing the experiment so that the system will not be movable and easy to work. So now we are going to see and start up the complete system and see how we perform the experiment for water temperature controlling using feedback flow control loop. Now after connecting the mains cord to the 220 volt AC socket, now you have to turn on the mains. Then we will turn on the PID and pump. The pump will be on when we are going to working with the pump. First we will set up the PID controller for this process. So right now you are seeing that PID controller is showing some value which is overloading condition. For this, this is because that we have not connected any of the input from the PID or the RTD. For this, we need patch codes so that connect T1 with T3 and T2 with T4. So you are now getting the input from the RTD here, and RTD is giving input to the PID controller, which is 22 degree centigrade right now. And for giving output to the heater control card, we need to connect T5 to T7 and T6 to T8. So these patch codes need to be connected for working. Now we have to enter all the parameters and setting values inside the PID controller. So we have to put all these values given in the user manual, the PID, hysteresis balance and other values to set up the PID controller in channel 1 and channel 6. Both the channel and working of the PID settings are given in this description as well in the user manual. Now we are going to do same. For this, we will press select for 3 to 5 seconds. We will now enter in the menu section. So this is the channel 1 menu. Press select to go in the settings for channel 1. That is P value. We have to set the P values approximately 9.5. So we need up and down keys. First we have to select, then we see start blinking the value in the green section in the lower side. Now we can increase and decrease the value by using this up and down key. So we have to set the value 9.5. Press select, the value has been entered. Now moving to the next part, press down key. This is the I value. The I value need to be 71. We need to set the I value 71 for this. So this is 71 that we have set here. Now moving to the D. So this is the D value. D value should be 13.7 described in the user manual. So we will change this to 13.7. Press select, enter. Now we go to hysteresis. This need to be 0. So it is 0 already. Then balance, this need to be 0. Then AR, this need to be 12. Sorry, this need to be 100. So we have set the value to 100. This is okay. Now moving to the next. This is reverse action. So this need to be reverse. You can change it to no, reverse no, normal, reverse forward, no, no. So we just need to change this to reverse here. So this is the reverse value. The action is reverse here. Now moving to the next parameter, SVL, set value low should be 0 and set value high should be 100. You can set the set value low and high according to your experiment. This is the standard values for this. Then we have TC1, this should be 1. PLC1 should be -5. So we have to set value in the negative. This is -5 now. Press enter. Then PHC1, the next parameter, this should be 105, so we change this to 105. Press select to enter the value. Now moving to the next parameter, PCUT should be 0, alpha should be 40, beta should be 100. So these are the all settings for this complete setup. To turning move to the home screen, press this back button. Now we have come to home screen. Now we enter the parameters for channel 6. For channel 6 value, again press select for 3 to 5 seconds. Now we have going to channel 1. After pressing up and down key, we now moving to the channel 6. Press select. So PVT need to be set PT6. So that is PT6 already set. Now we move into the next parameter, which is PVB, which should be 0. Then PVF should be 100. So all the settings for the channel 6 also done. Now we have entered the value. These are the factory settings value that can be changed according to the atmosphere and temperature of your own place. So you can auto tune the system as well for this. But before that, we will start the system and flow. Then we see how heater controlling of the temperature controlling of the water is going on. Then we auto tune the system and check how PID values will change according to our atmospheric temperature and other conditions. Now we will first turn on the pump by pressing the pump on button. Then after, as per the manual, we have to set the flow minimum or about 200 to 250 liters per hour. We will set the flow using rotor meter and adjust the flow using ball valve V1. So we'll first turn on the pump here. Now we need to set the water flow near about 200 liters per hour as described in the rotor meter. So we have to set this V1 valve, which is the output from the pump. Here you can see the puppet is going down. We need to set the flow near about 200 here. The flow is almost 200 liters per hour right now. Now we will turn on the heater MCB and then see how the PID controlling will work about the temperature. Now we will turn on the heater MCB. As the water from the geyser outlet is flowing, we can adjust the outlet valve of the geyser so that the water inside the geyser will remain for some time to get heat up. Now we'll turn on the MCB here. Here you can see, as I turn on the MCB, the indications on the geyser are now light up, and the red indication is for power on, and blue indication is giving the heating coil is in working and temperature is heating inside. You can also observe the temperature is slightly increasing, water temperature, which is sensed by the temperature transmitter or displayed on the PID controller. Right now we have already given the set point of 40 degree for this, so we can change the set point. We will start setting the set point near about 35 for this and press select. Here you can see the bar graph is showing heater control card is in working with the complete setup. The output is going on and off, and according output to the reaching set point from the PID controller is providing to the heater coil, and output or the actual temperature is sensed by the temperature transmitter, which is RTD for this, and the feedback as an input to the PID controller is giving through the RTD setup. In some time we will reach our temperature process and the set point of 35 degree of the water. Here you can see the water temperature is now, actual temperature is showing on the PID controller is 34 degree and set point is 35. The water is increasing. In some time we will get the actual set point that we have provided to the PID controller and control temperature is provided through this control loop. It will take time according to the temperature of the atmospheric value. Here you can see the set point has been achieved. If the temperature goes on increase, the heater control card or the PID controller will provide according output to the lowering the temperature, so that heater inside the heating inside the geyser will turn off and temperature set point will be maintained. The bar graph is showing current output of the heater control card, and as the temperature will increase, the output will be changes accordingly. Now if we change the set point to another set point, the working of the complete flow system will again change. So we'll increasing the set point to 40 now. Press enter. Here you can see the output from the PID controller is increased because there is lot more heating is required through the set point, and the difference or the deviation is very higher right now. In some time we will again reach our second set point, which is 40 degree. So you have to enter the different set points. Just remain and make sure that you do not provide any set point more than 60 degree, because the heater capacity to heat up the water is 60 degree is maximum. Here you can see we are now reaching our new set point, and temperature output or the heater control card output from the PID controller is continuously varying according to our set point. Here you can see we have reached our set point again. So that's how we control the water temperature using PID controller with this complete trainer system. Now we can also change and see the auto tuning of the PID controller as per the system settings. So for auto tuning the system, press select one time. This is the manual mode, which is in off right now, and we move to the AT menu, and when we press turn this to the on and select, the system will auto tune the system. This will take one or two cycles of heating control, and as the system recognizes all the system parameter and setting according to the ambient temperature and different other conditions, the system will be auto tuned accordingly. This changes the PID controller setting. Inside that we have entered the PID values that will be changed according to our ambient temperature and other conditions for the complete temperature sensing system. This can be varied to location and on to on settings. The settings that has been entered for the first process, this is the basic design settings or the factory basis setting that can be used and can be set up accordingly. So auto tuning blinking is now showing, you will see. So this will auto tune the system in some time automatically. Here you can see the system has been auto tuned right now, and this is showing the temperature set point is 30 and actual temperature is 32. So that's why bar graph is showing very no output for heater controlling. So we do not require any of the heating for the water, and the water is continuously going cooling down on ambient temperature. So this was the basic system to control the water temperature using feedback control. We now see the SCADA system while communicating the complete trainer system for the SCADA, and see monitoring and working of the system, and all the parameters and data will be provided on the SCADA as well. So now we are going to see SCADA controlling of this complete system as well. Now for SCADA setup, we have to provide the and open the folder provided with the kit, which is 5231. After opening the folder, you will find the SCADA software folder, in which we will find the LFP SCADA installer. This is the SCADA setup file. You have to install the SCADA using the SCADA setup file. Then you also have to install the USB driver software here. So USB driver is required to communicate the USB to UART bridge. So this is for Windows 7 and 8 for PUBG PID, and this is for Windows 10. You can use as per your operating system. Both the installation folder are given. So we have already installed our USB card or USB software here. So this is the USB cable that is connected inside the panel that we have already discussed earlier. Now we will connect this cable to our PC and go to device manager. In the device manager, as you connect the cable, you will find the cable as per the COM port. So after connecting the cable, you will see the COM port here in the port section. In the COM port, you will see Silicon Labs CP210 USB to UART bridge. This is connected at COM2. So we need to enter the COM2 value in the SCADA software. Now we minimize this and open the SCADA software. So this is the temperature controller SCADA. So we need to open the temperature SCADA. This is the executable file for this. As I double click on the file, the SCADA will be open. If it is asked to no hard key found and run as demo, press yes. Here you can see the SCADA screen is open now. In the water temperature controller, now in the SCADA setup, this is the complete MIMIC diagram that we have also seen on the front panel of the trainer. In this, we press Ctrl Alt plus S, and here we need to enter the PID COM port, which is our COM port 2. So we'll enter COM2 and press enter and press save. Here save settings will be asked. So we'll save the settings. And as I save the setting, you can observe the temperature, which is our set point, is giving here 35, and the PID output is 105%, and the actual temperature is 30, which is also sensed by the RTD transmitter and given to the PID controller. Here you can press on the PID section here. As you press, click on the PID sensor, PID screen, you will get this window opening here. So this is showing the actual temperature, which is process value, and set point 35 value, and wall output percentage design is also. Now all the both the bars are also given here. You can set the point from here also. You can see I have changed the set point to 30 from 35, or you can change the set point by entering manually here. So we'll change the test set point to 30, and same set point is changes on the PID controller as well, where you can see the same temperature reading has been changed to 30. That was 35 earlier. Now we again change the temperature in the SCADA mode as well. So we'll change the temperature to 40 by just enter the value here, and temperature set point has been changed. So by this You can control the actual temperature on the complete board as well. You can also observe the temperature is now again changed to 40 on the PID controller as well. So actual temperature is 29 and temperature set from the SCADA control is 40 degree right now. Similarly, if we on the system again and control the complete temperature according to our set point, we can observe different graphical outputs as well. So we'll first turn on the system. Just press pump on button from here. As I turn on the pump, the working started. Also, we need to on the heater MCB that I have turned off. Always on the heater MCB after turning on the pump, and turn off the heater MCB before turning off the pump. So heater MCB is now turned on and temperature is quietly increasing. You can also see the tuning graph for this. So this is our set point value, that 40 that we have set the set point, and from here we are seeing the temperature is increasing continuously up to 40 degree. This is now 35 degree, and output of the PID controller is now going decreasing because the temperature or set point is about to reach. All the values can also be seen on the trend graph here. So this is the trend graph, this is the process value graph here, set point versus time graph, process value versus set point time graph also. You can see the process value is now matched up to the graph. Process value plus set point plus output, all the graphs are given here, and deviation is about 4% right now. So we will change the temperature or deviation accordingly. Deviation is almost zero and going to zero again. We need to make the, or we required to make the deviation as lower as possible. So process value is 41 right now and set point is 40 in the trends graph, and the output is now decreasing as the set point is going to reached. Also, you can generate the reports for the SCADA system as well. Just click on the report icon and you will get all the report view for the SCADA. The data logging will be going on about every minute. All the data from PID 1 value, PID 2 value, PID 1 process value, set point and PID output percentage will be logged at every minute. You can Excel the report in export in Excel form. Also, the graphical report is provided here as well. And the tabular report, the same table can be printed directly to connected printer with your system. So that was the SCADA controlling of the complete system after setting up or getting all the data from the SCADA. Press exit and you will exit from the complete setup. The video of the computer screen might be some reflection, might have some reflection issues, but SCADA can be working completely in your PC. This was the basic demonstration of all complete system of water temperature controller using feedback control loop. And after working with the complete setup, first turn off the MCB of the heater so that water inside or the heater coil will not be in operation without the water. And now you can turn off the pump from the pump button here. And while working with this kit, make sure to do the careful arrangement of complete setup, as we are working with the warm water and the heater control card, with the dangerous, can be dangerous for the inappropriate operations. and also all the description about the kit and trainer kit are given in the user manual as well. You can refer to user manual for getting detailed explanation and detailed instructions about the experiment and practical, and to learn about the different parts, how they are working. Also, while working with this kit, if you find more difficulties than this, also you need to follow the experiment as I suggested and as I described in this video as well. And also, if you find difficulties while working with this kit, you can contact to Tesca Technologies Private Limited for all type of support. Thank you.